Jonathan and I have been attending RT for several years. We've been married for 9 of those years. And in those 9 years, we've faced a lot of different things. One of the greatest battles that we faced was when I was 21, I was diagnosed with ovarian cancer as a result of 3 major surgeries. I had a partial hysterectomy. And although I was very fortunate to survive, even to this day, I talk to physicians who cannot believe that I went through 3 major surgeries and never had to have chemotherapy. But as a result of my cancer, it would make having children very difficult. We always knew we wanted to have children, but we were experiencing just a hard time achieving that. We always believed that God had given us that promise. I saw so many people, our friends, having children, and never once did we ever were angry at them or anything like that. We shared in their joy, but in the quietness of our hearts, you know, we began to just almost just be mournful of the fact that we didn't have any children of our own. After months became years that were going by, and we still had not become pregnant, we began to speak to a lot of medical professionals to get their opinions and advice as to things we might be able to try and do. There was many times that Jonathan would come in because I had to go through so much physically in my body to even go through these treatments. Jonathan just used to be shake sometimes and cry and just say, if you want to give up, just give up. You don't have to do this. I don't want you to do this. It just broke his heart to see me in so much pain all the time. But for me, it wasn't just about the pain. It was about the reward of possibly having a baby. I'll never forget the day when Jonathan and I found out that we were actually pregnant. It was 3 o'clock in the morning and we were laying there, and I had insomnia really bad. I had decided to slip out of the bed and go into the bathroom and, you know, go ahead and test. And there it was. It said pregnant. I just began yelling for Jonathan. Jonathan, get in here, get in here. And I said, look at this. And he looked, and he kind of like had to do a double take because he just could not believe his eyes. It was the day after Thanksgiving, and it was late in the evening, and I started not feeling so well, so I was gonna go upstairs to go to bed. And while I was walking up the stairs, I began to just gush blood all over the place. We got to the hospital and they immediately got us in triage to be seen. The doctor basically just told us, you know, Kelly, if your cervix is opened in any way, you've lost the baby. Hours started going by. Any of the symptoms they were telling me I was gonna have, I wasn't having them. We had some family members come in, and they basically, you know, would just hug us. Some speaking faith into us, others saying, basically, it's gonna be okay, you could try again. The doctor came in and immediately he did the ultrasound, and we saw our baby kicking her little legs, and my cervix was closed, everything was fine, and we just began to cry with joy because everything was going to be okay. The doctors couldn't explain what had happened. We just knew that the baby was okay. We had several incidents like this happen throughout my pregnancy. I spent so much time in the hospital. The day that she finally arrived and she was safe, I get emotional. We just knew that God had given us this precious little girl. He gave us Emily Elizabeth.